The more than a dozen 2020 Democratic candidates together have raised roughly $75 million. Now that's compared to President Trump's $30 million in 2020 funding. But the Democrats' first quarter fundraising is short of candidates in 2008. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi tells us now why those numbers are important. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Mark. Money alone doesn't win elections. You just ask Jeb Bush or Hillary Clinton. But with so many Democrats running for the White House, donations can reveal something. Which candidates are rising to the top? Which candidates are gaining the hearts of the base?
Bernie Sanders and O'Rourke seem to be doing very well with small dollar donors. Definitely gives you an indication, an early indication, of where the passion is on the base. But we've seen Mayor Buttigieg doing quite well recently too. So these things can change over the course of an election, depending on who's garnering the lion's share of media coverage.
Here's a look at the Democratic totals for the first 3 months of this year. Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders wins, taking in $18 million. Second is California Senator Kamala Harris with $12 million. Former Texas Representative Beto O'Rourke comes in third with just over $9 million. And South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg raised $7 million.
Democrats' $75 million first quarter is short. In 2008, the eight Democratic candidates took in $80 million. Some donors might be waiting on the sidelines, waiting for some of the more than a dozen candidates to leave the race. Also, former Vice President Joe Biden hasn't yet jumped in. A big test for all of these candidates will be in June, the first Democratic debate. Mark?
Correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.